All right, I want to show you some electrical outlet and light boxes that we used for this house and a couple that we did not. So this one is a standard box. We did not choose to use this one. Tough to water seal, tough to air seal. This is not the best application. So this can work in a non-air sealed area like a porch soffit. But for the house, we didn't use that. This one we worked out really well. It's made by Arlington. It's an FR101F. And this is one we used in this application right here for an electrical outlet. You can see that. It has a box on the back, some depth. You can seal up this with some caulking or some foam, and also your penetration where the wires go through. You can seal those up well. Has a nice flange for actually flashing, like you can see there. So this is one that we actually really like and use it. Feel like it would last quite a while. This is the Arlington inbox. We originally got this, thought we might use it, decided not to because we were concerned about these flanges part, or these kind of breaking off and not be able to replace this later. But you make up that, you can see the depth of this box. It's pretty significant. All of this is inside the wall and your outlet is all the way back kind of at this point right here. So you don't get a lot of just your site. It's pretty flush, like it doesn't stick out far. So this box here, you have to mount another cover on top, which sticks out a little bit farther, but it's definitely not much. And it's also, this one felt like a sturdier box. It would last longer. So this is the Arlington inbox. The model number on this was the DBVM1W. So another option is this FR420F. This is a light box, and the reason for using this is you get a little bit more depth out of this in comparison to the FR405F. This one is flat on the back. So if you need more room for conductors, this is a good option. Still gives you a flange to waterproof against. And also you do have to cut out the back of the zip sheathing or your sheathing on the wall in order to get this back. And then you'll have to caulk, you have to do this similar to this box where we had to actually wrap the zip tape around the opening first before we sealed this and put this on. So that's adds a little extra step, but if you need the room for the conductors, this is a good option. Allows you to waterproof and you can air seal it too. This is another one here. This is the FR405F. This one actually is like a little bit step up from a pancake box. Comes out with adjustable depths on it. This is a half inch and this is an inch and a quarter. And this has a flat back. It's recessed so you can put your connectors in there and it'll fit flat against the wall without cutting any sheeting. Works out real well. So this is one we used for a lot of lights on this house because we didn't need the extra room for conductors. This is where you see the stretch tape. We actually took and caulked around the back of this. We put stretch tape around the opening first, caulked this on the back, pushed it in, secured it with the screws, put tape up both sides, left the bottom open, then went ahead across the top, sealed that up, and then we put zip liquid flash on top of the screws that we secured it with.